the other one. Is this one better?
Yes.
I think neither is better.
Yes.
Yeah. No, for the Juma, our presenter, that the person working on this mic, for a
this building is nothing but really for bachelor.
It's matchless. And usually in the matchless system, you know, we have seats like this. I don't know if you've ever been to any of our matchlesses. And the host sits here and we speak relevant. We don't have mics forever, but we're trying to get as many people as possible. Again, welcome to our once a month documentary, once a month lecture series. We do our. How many of you been to the lecture series or documentaries before? Anybody? Anybody? Nobody? No one showing Sharad, huh? We have. You have? Well, it's hard. We use a dog. No more visa for you, because don't go to the immigration. You have to come to us a lot. My name is Nasir, NASIF. Managing Director of the Sheikh Mohammed Center for Cultural Understanding. It's a non-for-profit organization. Our aim is to structure for understanding. If you come to our center in Dira, and I'm sorry, Barabai, right along the tree, it's an apprenticeship visit. 6 days a week, we offer interaction with Emiratis through a meal or through a tour. Mosque. This mosque present here, Jumeirah. For the last 40 years, it's been holding 6 days a week. What we're doing tonight is that once a month we do a documentary about culture, we do about history. Tonight we have Berlin, and with me, Juma, Khalifa, is a gentleman who is writing extensively in marine life. If you ever see his books, you'll be like, wow, we're going to show you one of them tonight. But it's all in Arabic. So you have to learn Arabic. See? We should take in mind that if you come to Dubai, you have to learn Arabic. So the concept is that most of us folks in this country, we speak Arabic. Why would I speak English? Because I went to America, I studied in England after high school, I spoke Arabic, nobody understood me. So I started to speak English. Now I speak English fluently. See, the problem is everybody speaks Arabic fluently. That's okay. But again, we have a gentleman here that is amazing experience in the life of Berlin. Tonight we will talk for you Berlin, the third industry, diving for pearls, which is really our livelihood. Before we discovered oil and we became known as oil rich Arabs, we had a life. And we were somebody important in the trade principles of the stock market, the Gulf countries, especially here, the six GCC countries. People came from all over the world with boats full of goods and said, give me the best pearl you have. And Juma tonight is going to show you some real pearls and some culture pearls. In Japan invented culture pearls in 1920, slowly, slowly devaluated the natural pearls. And it became absolute non-value. So therefore, thank God, not too long right after that, we discovered oil. Otherwise, we would never have made UAE, there would never be Dubai by the sea. Marine is no water. And 120 degree temperatures for who's going to want to live here? How many of you would stay here that long? By the way, we stayed here since 1795. Just so you know, generation after generation, that's why, you know, we are born basically Emirati, but this is people who came and accepted to live in such high environment, or hot environment, or very rough environment, and survived for months, thick and thin. And under that, again, we are a renowned city. Throughout the world, with the efforts of visionaries such as Sheikh Rashid, who is the father of Sheikh Mohammed, who made it into a great city, which we continued pearl diving training through Jebel Ali Bor. We just facilitated the Jebel Ali Bor takes 1,352 containers every hour. And with the Maktoum Airport, you know, the World Central Airport, we will be the fastest shipping hub from here to anywhere in the world, or especially Middle East, Africa, and Europe, and Asia. For the next 20, 30 years, I don't think they will become a ship. So technically speaking, that was what Sheikh Mohammed's dad, and Sheikh Mohammed the Russian, who is our leader today, he established us as a tourist industry. And tourism, as you know now, people. So without further ado, now is the meeting to present the PowerPoint. You will speak in Arabic, inshallah, 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 inshallah. Thank you so much. He will explain the slide and I'm translating it into English. We can be together for about an hour. Is that okay with you? You good to go? Yes? All right. Send me.
اوزان اشكال اسماء كلها بتكون في 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 موضوع طبعا التسمية. أكثرية يعني من الإمارات أكثر الأسماء تكون من برا الإمارات. بنشوف طبعا الواسطة تجارة اللولو مش نسيب عندنا موسم الغوص، طاقم سفرة الغوص، متطلبات الغوص، وطريقة اللولو والمناحة والأهمية الاقتصادية اللي بنتكلم.
We have intro, we have the perling season, we have the people on the ship, their positions, the necessities of diving for perls, the concept of perls, what are they, and of course boating and traveling, and the economical, what we call it, importance of perling in the old days. So you can hear me with this? I think you turned it up a little bit. It's not on? Where is my technical support? Everybody needs to email Sheikh Mohammed, tell him we need more support for this nonprofit organization. Can you lower the speaker? Still too loud. Can you hear me now better?
It's just the echo, maybe.
It's too much echo. Bring the speaker closer and lower it. Okay, come on, ID.
Alright, shall we? Okay, guys. Introduction. طبعا السلامة قائد السفينة اللي ناخذها عدد السفن المناطق الغوص والبحر.
Safety, the captain of the ship, the number of boats, the area of which we went for perling and the sea. First thing.
فترات أو موسم الغوص مش.
The season of perling.
نشوف هي عندنا شهر طبعا يناير نشوف باللون الازرق جنوري فبراير مارس ابريل ماي جون جولاي اوغست سبتمبر اكتوبر نوفمبر ديسمبر. طبعا نشوف الالوان الزرقاء ما فيها غوص، ليش؟ لان فيها الفتره تكون فتره برد.
كولد جانيوري فبراير مارش هاف اوف ابريل نو دايفينج سوز ديسمبر نو دايفينج.
الحين بندش على شويه مسميات ومصطلحات للغوص لان الفتره.
We're going to mix Arabic between the English, which is the definition in Arabic, but we don't have it in English, okay? I'll say it in
English. الفترة الصفراء اللي داش على البرتقالي هاي يسمونها فترة الخانجية أو فترة الصيف. يعني شهر تقريبا شهر أربعة.
Half of April to half of May almost, it's the beginning of summer, خانجية. It's cold for us, alright?
طبعا الفترة كلها أربع شهور وعشرة أيام. نحن عندنا تعتبر فترة أن الريل الخرمة متوفي عنها، يعني عندنا نحن كمسلمين تعتبر فترة عدة اللي هي الأربع شهور وعشرة أيام، هي تعتبر يعني كأن الشخص هذا اللي رايح الغوص عن زوجته كأنه متوفي، مو يعني ما يقدر يرجع أو ما يرجع، فالفترة كلها أربع شهور عشرة أيام هي اسم البحر.
Maximum.
يعني أكثر مدة هذه اللي هي أربع شهور عشرة أيام، الفترة الأكبر شيء هذه.
Four months and 10 days exactly, according to Islamic Sharia law. If your husband was to die as a woman, you have to wait 4 months and 10 days before you get married again. So the diver will go for 4 months and 10 days exactly and come back. So she doesn't get married.
فالفترة اللي نشوفها واحد اثنين ثلاثة الأربع شهور هذه هي الفترة اللي تقريبا يخلص يبدا الغوص نهايته تقريبا في اول شهر 10 تقريبا شهر 6 و7 8 9 و10 اربع شهور.
Right about now we finished
خلاص
يعني just about now we خلاص finished. We now are coming back arriving from Berlin right about this time of the year. So a lot of you, how many of you knew that this was 4 months? Raise your hand, honestly. Yeah, see? Everybody used to think that we go there for 2 days and come back for 1 weekend. 4 months and 10 days. Plus, some people stayed more if they didn't have a wife, yes.
We
have questions and answers at the end, so. Yes.
فاللي هي الاربع شهور شهر 7 شهر 8 شهر 9 شهر 10 وياخذون 10 ايام، ليش؟ ياخذون ال 10 ايام على اساس ان الناس اللي الاولاد والحريم طبعا حد منهم رايح روس الجبال، حد رايح منهم لمنطقه العين على اساس انه هو حار ومنطقه مزارع وهذا، فيحسبون الفتره عشان يرجعون قبل لا يجون هذيلا تقريبا يومين ثلاث ايام الهرماتيه البيت، تجهز البيت، تنظف البيت على اساس ان عندها حسبه ان زوجها بيرجع من الروس تقريبا بعد يوم او يومين.
Yes, so it's really calculated for, just like you expect your husband to come back from the army as he served 1 year in Afghanistan or Iraq. This is also like a service, 4 months and 10 days. We did not stay by the sea these months because it's humid and very hot. We went into like places like Khawanid, where the farms, where it's cooler. The more inland you go, the cooler it is. So the ladies will count 2-3 days before the 4 months and 10 days are over. She and the kid will come back and they will clean up the house and get ready. Dad is coming back, hopefully with something good. It's exciting times and scary times. Because sometimes somebody didn't come back. Yes, ma'am?
Do they stay at sea for the 4 months?
For more?
For the time period?
Yeah, they stay inside. They don't come back, yes. يقول يعني تبوا بالبحر 4 شهور
ما يرجع
4 months and they don't come back yeah 4 months and days
يعني سبيل طولها تقريبا يقول 15 متر فيها يمكن 20 شخص يعيشون فيها 4 شهور كيف يعيشون؟ انت اليوم في غرفه يا زوجتك يا رياض
50 foot boats has 20 people and they live there for 4 months and 10 days and that's their Kevin Costner, you think invented something new? I always tell the people come see our life in the old days. We stayed inside, yeah.
زين عندنا نشوف في شهرين، شهر اكتوبر وشهر نوفمبر. هذين وصولهم لاسباب، طبعا خلص الفتره الكبيره اللي هي الاربع شهور خلصت يرجعون طبعا الغوص الخانجيه والغوص الكبير والرده والرديده، هاي كلها اسامي فترات غوص، لكن الفتره هذه في بعض الغواصين يرجعون، ليش يرجعون؟ لان هذا الغواص له ناخذه يطالب الغواص فلوس بعدها، اي فشو؟ هذول يرجعون يغوصون عشان يغوصون بس المناطق القريبه مو بس يروحون المناطق البعيده، فالفتره تقريبا يروحون الصبح يرجعون المساء يمكن عليه 100 درهم، يمكن عليه 30 درهم، يمكن عليه 50 درهم، لازم يرجعها، حتى هم قبل لا يبدون، قبل لا يطلعون هني، انا انت كان واخذها مالك كغواص، يتم تعطيني 100 درهم، بالمثل غواص يقول حصل 150 درهم ويروح الغواص. راح وطلعت حسبه، حسبوا المحصول وطلع 150 يعطونك ال 150 لكن تم ال 150 بال الاوليه عليك. ما تروح. تبغي تنتقل الى سفينه اخرى لازم هاي انا اعطيك انت ال 150 درهم على اساس اني انا انتقل الى سفينه اخرى.
So really it's almost like a concept of divorce owns the people. So if you, I owe you money, some people borrow from the head of the boat, the local that's called, the guy who owns the boat to take everybody permit. Let's say I give you an advance. Then at the end of the season, you did not catch anything and you ended up with nothing. So now you owe me money. So now you can go back October, November and try to make shorter periods, maybe a day, a week, till you catch something to pay off. You have to pay off. And this is how sometimes people went for 6 months, technically speaking, just so they can catch up. Like you go and dive in front of another country. I mean, all six countries, we took out almost more than 1,200 boats.
صارت فيها في الحرب العالمية الأولى طبعاً اتجهوا الناس لأن كان المضيق وايد مشاكل عليه وصارت مجاعة عندهم فاتجهوا بعض الناس يغوصون في سريلانكا يغوصون في الصومال.
Yeah, we had a problem World War One here. There was a problem with the Hormuz Strait, and so therefore some people went to the Ivory Coast and Sri Lanka and Somal in front of their coast and over there too.
Yeah.
And we'll give you guys time to
نشوف ما في فترات روح يقول لا غوص هني شوف هني الخانجية وهني الغوص الكبير
This is the big, the red is the big timing.
هي عز فترة الحرب طبعا هذه.
Yellow is preparation. You blue like you said no and the other yellow right there in the bottom as you see September, October is the
I gotta go back, I gotta get some more, I'm not done yet. October, November, we gotta finish it up, my last chance, that's it. Let's go, you know.
القاحة طبعا القاحة نشوف مناطق قريبة اللي على دبي يمكن 5 مايل 6 مايل يروحوا للصبح يرجعون بس هاي فترة وهاي فترة.
This is something you can do in a day. You go and come back, hopefully you get lucky. That's alright. طيب now
عندنا طاقم السفينة الغوص.
Yeah, the people on the ship, they are
روح مشي ايوه بس وقف عند السرداب ارجع
سرداب
طبعا الكلمه ليس بعربيه الكلمه فارسيه لو نقصد السين والراء والالف والدال واللام شو تصير؟ سر ودل
ايوه
شوف الكلمه يقول لك سر ودل يعني هذا اللي هو يصير يدلينهم فنقسم الكلمه من نص السين والراء بروحها مثلا والدال والدال واللام بروحها طبعا الاسم فارسي وليس بعربي.
This is Persian language. Sirdar, we have of course, if you look at our Emirati language, we have Urdu in it, we have Persian in it, Arabic, all of it. It's mixed lingo. So Sir, I don't know if you know, if you follow our Speak Emirati Instagram, Sir means walk. Dal means found. Or you got what you were looking for. So Sirdar, which is really the head of the Amir Ghos, which is the
Sirdar. Sirdar, اللي هو يقود السفن كلها مثلاً دبي في سردار. هو القائد هذا يعني نشوف مثلاً ملكة النحل وين ما تتحرك الخلية وين كله وياها. فسردار مثلاً في دبي في سردار هو اللي حرك السفن هو اللي يدليهم بالأماكن الخصبة اللي فيها المحارم اللي فيها اللولو. فهم دايم يتحققون على
عدد سفن ممكن يكون في دبي يعني
500 سفينه ممكن 500
سفينه. So the head of the ships, Sirdar, this guy who goes and points out the area where we're going to go dive, he leads up to 500 ships. The ship he is on, it is him who is going to go today and say, this area, Yama, go ahead, you know, stop and we're going to all dive and we're all going to find whatever is there. Good?
فهي هي سردار طبعا سردار في دبي في راس الخيمه في الفجيره في غزوه في الفجيره في راس الخيمه طبعا الفجيره ما فيها غوص اهل الفجيره او بعضهم كان يهني اهل عمان ما فيها غوص طبعا ساحل الامارات من راس الخيمه الى دبي يختلف حتى عن غوص اهل ابو ظبي ليش؟ لان ابو ظبي مناطق ضحله لدرجه حتى ان حتى الهريم كان يشارك في مهنه الغوص يسمونه غوص المينا بمعنى شو؟ يوم تصير المد اخر يعني الجزر اخر شيء فيبدا هم شو؟ يجمع المحار طبعا الماء يكون وايد واطي فكانت نسبه من النساء كان هن اللي يشتغلن في هذه المهنه وخاصه في ابو ظبي فقط يعني مو في الامارات.
It's like in Abu Dhabi a woman could go collecting because when the tides were low it was so shallow that you could actually go walk for a good bit of distance and you could just collect the oysters and open them. And see if you get lucky and blessed. Where, let's say, Fujairah and Amman, there is no oysters there. You had to really come this way. So, really, the cost of UAE was different from one place to another. Also, plus when you know all the ships went out of all the GCC countries, there are areas for everybody, there are areas for certain countries. Yes.
في شوية يعني رعابة من الغواصين لأن كانوا كلهم رجال ما يشوفون النساء فكانوا يتمنون يشوفون عندهم النساء فشو كان واحد من الغاصه يقول قصيده او بيتين انه يتمنى ان يشوف يعني حرمه تروح الغوص فيقول ليت اخلي يصير الغوص اسوق ويغوصون علي ومن نبرت شفت ديش الزلوف ترد الروح عليها.
Yeah, so the one of the points that the Berdar used to say is, we wish women were come with us and Berdar with us, we would be much happier in this strange sea, boring sea, with just a bunch of men together.
ننتقل إلى نوخذة.
Alright, so this is نوخذة.
طبعا هذا هو قائد السفينة، هذا هو قائد السفينة، هو الآمر وهو النهي، بس الغواصين نوعين، في غواص يقولون غواص خلوي بمعنى ان خالي من الديون هو صاحب السفينه وهو الممول وهو الامر وهو الناهي. في غواص يسمونه غواص اجعدي بمعنى شو؟ بس جاي ويالس في السفينه، هذا يالس ويعطي الاوامر مستاجر في السفينه مستاجر، يعني ما السفينه مبله. فهم يختلفون.
So two divers, there is a diver that owes nobody no money, and he actually is funding the ship, and he is actually leading the ship. And there is the guy who's just sitting there, and he really works as a leader of the ship, but he doesn't own the ship, nor that he has, you know, money invested in the ship. It's his job to be the manager, let's put it this way. And there is the manager who really actually is the owner. So there is two types of leaders here. It's your business and you run it, or you just there working and you are running it. But it's not your ship and it's not your funding, it's not your capital.
طبعا هذا انه خذا المساجر ما يقدر يبيع اللولو في البحر طبعا لازم يرجع الى الاخره هذا
So if it was my boat and I hired you to go run the boat while I'm sitting in land, I did not want to go for the season, you cannot sell. You collect all the birds, when you come back, ask me the judge of where to sell it and how much to sell it for. But if I was in sea, and this is something we can talk about later on, is that some boats from the other countries came to us while we were at sea trying to catch, you know, fresh yellow. Come on, now let's deal with it. So there's two differences. Good? Bad?
اللي بعده طبعا هو هذا اللي تكلمنا عن الجعدي نمشي عنه.
Good.
This is very good. القاعد اللي كنا عن القاعد. المجدمي. المجدمي الحين نشوف هذا الولد اللي جاي بماي جاي عندك انت اعطاك الماي يقول لك شو تبغاني اسوي؟ تقول له سير هات لي دبه ماي، سير تقول لهم يسوون العشاء، تقول لهم يخطفون الشرع. فمعنى مجدمي اللي هو في المقدمه اللي هو قدام، هو اللي ياخذ الاوامر من اللي واخذها ويعطيها للبحاره كلهم او الغواصين.
This is the position of the assistant of the نوخذه, which is the captain of the ship. That was a very sophisticated system. Just so you know, I mean, we go through this. ممكن احنا نستعجل شوي بس انا اقول لهم انه كان يعني نظام كل واحد له شغلته. Everybody had their position and everybody became good at their position. When they go from one ship to another, they are famous from their family and with their name that they are so good at that. So this is the assistant captain. He takes orders from the captain and then he tells everybody and he like dictates to everybody by the order of the captain.
فنحن نقول دايم مثلا يعني يسحبون يبولون والحليب اللي بيسلم.
This is the men who get the birds and the women wear it. So this is the
best. زين ماشي.
What's his name? What's his name? Sorry.
مجدمي.
ها مجدمي.
The assistant, the مجدمي.
مجدمي.
Yeah, which is really the forwarder. If you want me to translate these things exactly, Sirdan, we said the guy who goes and finds, let's put it that way. Nokhada, which is really captain. Jadi, which is really captain, but it's not actually financially funding and he is not the owner of the boat, he's just working, so I would say he's the manager, let's put it that way, of the boat. Jadini is the guy who assists the captain of the or the manager of the boat. And the race, which is what the third diver himself. This is the guy who pulls the diver. So there is the diver, Ghais, and there is the guy who pulls him. Each has their job.
أكثر واحد يتعب هو طبعاً. الغواص أول 10 أيام ما يقدر يفتح عيونه. يعني بعد ما يغوص 10 أيام تصير عنده تقرحات ما يقدر يشوف لأن جسمه طري. السيف يعني العظام إيده تطلع ما يقدر بس الله حتى يجيبه عن خشمه. من التقرحات هاي اول 10 ايام هاي المشاكل اللي تصير عند السيف وعند الغيث.
First 10 days complications. First of all, the diver from the salty water, because there's no goggles, guess what? They cannot see. This is the repercussion of the very first 10 days. Immediately, you have this, what we call the side effects. And the guy who pulls the diver, his hands become so swelled up and so infected that they smell. He cannot even touch his face with them. Yeah, now all rich Arabs, nobody knows this stuff. You want that for a while, almost for a
while. Yes,
yes.
طبعا نحن بناخذ السير بعدين بعد عند السير. طبعا الرضيف هذا مساعد للسير.
This is the guy who helps the guy who pulls. So of course these guys overcome their what we call it side effects after 10 days, they will get cured. we have all kinds of remedies, and, you know, herbs and whatever, then they will go back to being normal. But it's usually when you have not done it for 8 months and you go and you start diving, the first 10 days are the toughest, because now you have to pay heavy price for having started to exercise or do this. And so this is the guy that helps, the guy who pulls the... So there's two guys. One guy that pulls him, one guy that helps him, takes the basket.
هذا الرضيف اللي يصير البحر عمر يعطونه حبل زيادة الله يسر. فالسير ما يقدر لازم يكون شخص يساعده.
يعني يساعدنا لانه
غزير لان البحر صار عميق وفي تيار فلازم يكون
So therefore sometimes when there is waves underneath like undertow and it's very deep they happen to go too deep the guy gets tired the other guy begins to help pull the rest of the way because the diver has to rely on being pulled 100% he's not going to do this with his he's too tired already just pull me out
بنتكلم على امراض بعدين شويه.
اوكي.
طبعا التباء هذا تباء ولد صغير يمكن عمره تقريبا 12 سنه 13 سنه اول سنه يطلع الغوص يبدا ينزل يتدرب على الغوص بس.
This is the 12 years old kid that begin to learn. Sometimes you go to train at younger age. Why? Because your family needs money, maybe your dad died. Some previous family, now you have to sustain your family and you go and you begin to train from 12 years old, you go dive and you come back shorter periods, but now it's the beginning, Taba. That's his name. Good? Now we have Jalas.
Jalas. هذا جلاس بعد اولاد في عمره تقريبا 10 سنوات هذول شو شغلتهم؟ رايحين لمجموعه يا سنين جروب يا سنين يبون يشبون المحار يسوون يفرقون ست اشخاص مثلا ست اشخاص يفرقون يابوا هني بعد مجموعه وخلوها هني تفرق بس يابوا الشخص هذا شو يسوي؟ يراقب عليهم ليش؟ عشان ما تصير سرقه يمكن واحد يصل دار كبير ويحطها تحت السعر فكل هذول الاولاد الصغار طبعا كل ست اشخاص ينسون المكان يفرقون المحار طبعا المحار ما يفرق لا السيف ولا الغيص ولا النخبه اللي يفرقون المحار هم هذول الجلاس.
So the 12 years old is the kid who's beginning to dive actually and learn to dive, but the jalas is the kid who's younger, 19 years old, and they're the ones that open the oysters.
واسم الجلاس جالس كل
جالس. Yeah, because they sit and they just open oysters, oysters. Imagine their hands with the knife, you know. But these kids, they have to, this is again, and there is always six and one watching them, making sure that they don't swallow the pearl. The best way to steal a pearl is to swallow it.
حتى لو صار قاعد يطلعونها منه شو يسوون له؟
يشربون حلول. حلول يا. So really if they notice that somebody swallowed one and they got, you know, they watch him, they make him, you know, with some liquid, they take everything out of him till they spend it 100%. Because it's very serious business, you know. And there are people who got away with it, just so you know. There are people who did hide here and there that one bird that made a difference in their life. But it's called stealing, but again, whether you're Muslim or not, at the end of the day, temptation is there. Good? Now we go to...
طبعاً هذا السكوني والنهام والطباخ. طبعاً بنشرح بسرعة عنهم بعدين بنتكلم عن الطلاش. طبعاً الطباخ الكوكي مالك.
Okay, so the cook, we have a cook, tabakh,
naham, and السكون. السكون طبعا اللي يمسك الدفة مال السفينة، هذول طبعا بعد يختلفون عن الطاقة. بس هم يشوفون النهام يعني وايد مهم. يعني يشل نهمات. هب وبرد يا هو يعني عندهم. يخفف عنهم.
Keeps them with his humming. You know, like the army. When you are marching, you keep saying, you know, what do you call it, like the words or the sings. So this is it. Huh? Tabakh is the cook, Naham is the singer, and Sukuni is the guy who steers the ship. Good?
طواش معين. في طواش في البحر وفي طواش في البر. الطواش البحر يروح حق الغواصين تقريبا بعد شهر ونص يا دوب انهم شو؟ جمعوا محار وحصلوا فيه لولو. مثل ما قلت لكم ساعه رجع لي ما يبيع لولو، طبعا الغواص الاخروي هو اللي يبيع بس. طبعا الطواش هذا اذا يجيك يسوي لك قراءه العيون يشوفها. يعرفك اذا انت بتبيع ولا لا. بعدين في قانون عندهم، اذا انت على السفينه طواش ويلا اخذها، انا مو من حقي اني انا اطلع واعرف البيع. بعد ما ينزل من حقي اني انا اطلع على السفينه واشوف اللولو اللي عنده، خاصه اذا دانه عرفوا عنها طواويش.
So really, technically speaking, there is those who are the what we call it sellers and buyers. So there is the ones who go actually to the sea and get on the ships and negotiate with whatever you already have to buy from you right there and then. And those who wait and wait for those who don't sell at sea and wait to come back. So technically speaking, it's a warfare. You could look at it that way of who goes out. Who can you convince to sell, who doesn't sell, who's known to sell, who's not known to sell, who's known to pay very high price, who actually the news travels around quickly, who actually found a good one or a good find with ship. And again, it's really, and sometimes they keep it secret. So this is something.
الحين بنشوف كيف طريقة البيع علشان ما يصير انقلاب على انه اخذها في السفينه بكم باع، ما يبغي الغاصه وطاقم السفينه بكم باع، نشوف الحين براميل انا وانت بنسوي حركه تحت الحركه هاي، هي الطريقه كيف تصير على اساس انه ما حتى ما يتكلم وياه الطريقه عنده، بس تخلي شوي المايك ونشوف الطريقه.
So this is what we're gonna do now, we're gonna enact, let's say like if I am a buyer, I come to the captain of the ship to buy from him. Okay. So therefore, I'm gonna buy in secret without the rest of the crew knowing that I bought from him, because if they know, they're gonna start asking how much, why did you sell it for this much, why didn't you wait till
the
you know, it begins to be a problem. So therefore, what's gonna happen?
عشان هم بس يشوفون مثلا قالتي 3000 على اساس كلها هي تكون كذي ما حد.
So now he pointed for me three fingers, that's 3000.
مثلا كذي قال له 2000، قال له كذي مثلا الجاري ماخذينها عندك. فهاي الطريقه بس هم يكونون مزحفينها وتحت الايد علشان ما يعرفون.
The communication is under the scarf or under the hand. So the guys are looking but they don't know what's the offer, did he sell or not sell, did he accept, they have no idea. Cool? Again, it's really a life. In all that it means, yes sir.
What is the sign of acceptance?
Signs of what? Acceptance? Well, we did it under the handkerchief. I will show you later. I have to hug your hand. It's a sign. Yeah.
ماشي؟ طبعا طواش طبعا هو اللي يبيع ويشتري له.
So as you see, every person has a title. And this, they become known, they are good at that. In the old days, today we have ID, we have business degrees, we have, in the old days we have these professions.
طبعا العملة كانت تربية عندي.
And of course, Indian rupees was the exchange currency for selling.
شوف طبعا عندنا الادوات الغوص، نشوف عندنا المفلقه اللي هي تقريبا عباره عن مثل السكين، ونشوف الشخص كيف يفتح المحل. نشوف هاي الادوات اللي هي عندنا الفطام، الديين، الخبر، الحصار، الشمشول، اللباس، اليده، المفلقه، الزيت. كل هاي بنتكلم عنها طبعا.
If you go to our Speak Emirati Instagram, we tweeted all these names and we put their descriptions too.
طبعا عندنا الفطام. نشوف الفطام عندنا هني طبعا.
This is the farm which is really the nose clip.
عندنا هني الفطام. هذا عظام، هذا تقريبا قرن قزام.
Okay. ايوه. There it is. This is the nose clip. من ايش مصنوع؟
طبعا. في عندنا قرن غزال وعندنا غروف ماعز، الظرف مال الماعز، ليش يستخدمونه؟ لانها ما تهين في الماء وما تخترق وبعدين طبيعيه. هي طبيعيه يعني هذه ما تكون.
Either the horn of a gazelle or the hoof of the goat. Because they don't get ruined in salty water underneath because they sit there on your nose the whole time.
شوف يعني
your nose is wet. You clip it to your nose. Good? So this is how, as best as you can, I'm not gonna stuff myself. I'll let you pass it around later. Okay. So this is the one of the tools. All right. We saw the knife and we saw the what do we call it? The.
طبعا عندنا عظام سلاحف. طبعا استخدموا كل البيئة اللي عايشين فيها. عندهم عظام سلاحف وعندهم قرون قزاز وعندهم ظلف مال الماعز.
Also, we could use the shell of the turtle. So that's it for the yeah.
طبعا عندنا الدين اللي هي السلة اللي يجمع فيها المحا. السلة اللي يجمع غواص فيها المحا.
This is the basket which you collect the oysters in. Good.
الخبر هذيل طبعا هذيل ينصنع مو من اي جلد ينصنع من جلد البقر ليش؟ لان جلد البقر وايد وايد سمين فيحط الغواص بس على اطراف اصبعه كانه جلابس على اساس اول ما يجمع محاه ما تتجرح ايده فيعتبر جلد غليظ وجلد سميك لو نشوفه.
Cow hide to stick on the tips of your fingers. This becomes like your glove. So when you are down there and in the sea getting the oysters, you don't have to worry about which angle. You just grab and it doesn't cut your fingers. So this is the what covers for the tip of your fingers, and they are made from cow hide.
هني عندنا أخبار عمر يمكن 320 سنة.
This this is 320 years.
طبعا واصل تقريبا 75,000 درهم لليوم بس نحن مو راضيين نبيع عندنا في الجبل.
So far جمعه is not selling it.
من البحرين مو من الامارات هذا يبينا من البحرين.
75,000
اصلي يعني هذا اصلي.
Original 75,000 درهم.
مش راضيين نبيع بعد.
ها؟
مش راضيين نبيع.
ان شاء الله ما تبيع ان شاء الله يتم وياك ان شاء الله شيء طيب.
طبعا عندنا
But give it back, give
it back. عندنا حصات الحصى هي اللي تنزل الغواص.
This is the weight, guys. It's a stone. حصى من وين؟
هاي حصى هاي تشوف الحصى هاي ايش قدها؟ يعني نفس هذا بس هاي نوع فيها من الرصاص او نوع فيها خاصة للغوص بس.
بس من وين
يجيبونها؟ يجيبونها من الجبال.
الجبال.
لا مو من عمان، يجيبونها من جبال فارس. طبعا الفتحة اللي فيها يفتحونها بطريقة عجيبة يعني يبون نوع إذا سمعت عن الخيل يصبون الخيل ويخلونه تقريبا أسبوع يبدأ يتفاعل 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 ويبدأ يأكل هذه المحاة طبعا هذا الحبل يحط الغواص ريله داخل الفتحة هذه وينزل.
Very solid rocks come from the mountains of Persia also Iran again and it's really Rasas, you know what we make,
Lead.
It's really lead drops, and the way they make the hole in them by pouring a liquid of some sort. At that time it was available, and it's a known thing, and it eats through it until they make the hole, and then it becomes the way to drop the weight so they can start the boat. And so, of course, also for you as the diver, you tie it to your feet so you can go down.
هذا الهيدل هذا الزيبل نحن شفناه من ساعه عنده هذا الزيبل الزيبل طبعا
نفس الصوره
هي نفس الصوره بس هن حبلين الغواص عنده حبلين في يسمونه حبل الهيدل ليش سموه حبل الهيدل لانه في الايد هذا الحبل الانقاذ طبعا هو حبل الانقاذ موجود عنده لو نرجع شويه تشوف بعد مش مشي شوية بعد مشي هاي طبعا اللي نحط تشوفها حبر اليدة هذا اللي يستخدمه الغواص فيه مشي شوية
So there is the rope that the diver holds in his hand and there is the one that they
في شيء بين الغواص وبين السير هذا اليدة شوف هذا اللي في يديه غواص إذا أنا غواص وأنت سير أنا اللي اختار ليش؟ يمكن أنا عندي مشكلة وياك يمكن تخليني تحت الماي هي أنا اللي اختارك مو أنت اللي تختارني السير هو اللي اختار الغواص يمكن أنا عندي مشكلة وياك على أرض على بيت على شيء أنت بتخليني تحت الماي أنا اللي أسحب كغواص كسير هل اللي يجرب
الغواص يختار السير
لا الغواص اللي يختار السير على اساس انه ما يقدر به او ما يخليه
نعم so really the diver always also has a choice of who is the safe who is the guy that's going to put him out of water because there's got to be a trust relationship we have a problem I owe you, and then all of a sudden you kind no, I got you. You stay, and I'm like, oh, I forgot to pull you out or something. You know? Again, it's really, it's a whole life. But now the next one.
الشمشور طبعا هذا الشمشور اللي هو الصوال الصغير اللي تشوفه تطلع الدائره عليه
this is the what we call it the
هذا السهم الفرس
the boxers for the diver alright and then
هذا يستخدم للجيلي فيش يعني الغواص يستخدم اللبس هذا
جيلي فيش that's what you wear to protect yourself from so if you want to go swim at kite beach you can wear
طبعا عمل الغواص اليومي شرحناه بتمشي عليه طبعا يغوص من الصبح الى
الدايفر من متى بيتصل متى يبتدي
ها
الغواص
في حد من النوافذ شديدين يعني قبل ما يطلع النوع ينزل الغواص
يعني على طلوع الشمس
ايه لا قبل تطلع الشمس
قبل الفجر
ايه قبل يعني الفجر تقريبا ينزلها والمغارب يوقفون
مغارب so it could be from before sunrise to sunset that's like 12-14 hours diving
يغوص خمس مرات ويستريح مرة.
Five times you dive and one you rest.
يغوص خمس ويوقف يريح مرة.
How many times per day every diver dive?
How many times? Five and you rest. Five and you rest. كم المدة؟
How
is it? المدة تحت. الفترة اللي تم تحت الماء تقريبا دقيقة ونص أقل يعني.
Minute and a half underneath.
How do you 10 meter, 20 بس اللي عندهم 20 متر هذا يصير عندهم سفرات اعماق.
ايه 20 متر you have side effects. It's not easy. 10 meter is reasonable. Good question. كم محاور في السلة؟
في السلة حد يجيب 50 حد يجيب 100 حد يجيب 10 حد يجيب
100
لأن المسا اللي أنت جايبنا بروحه اللي جايبنا أنا بروحي
كل يعني دقيقة ونص كم محاور كل مرة
على حسب المكان اللي هم يوصلون
It's really it's up to the luck of, you know the basket can fit quite a few but you could be for the day 100 for the day 150 Well, it depends. Some people luck out, some people don't. وكل واحد
يحسبون المغرب يحسبون عنهم. يلعب عياب مثلا انت قالوا مثلا يابو انت جبت مثلا 10 20 كيس او 15 كيس انا يا بيت مثلا نص كيس. قال لي نروح نسوي له ماريا.
So really between the divers, one has 50, one has 100, one has 150, it becomes an average of what does today look like. So those who are 50 and 20, what's going on? We have people with hundreds and you have people with nothing. So they become almost like shunned out and people are making fun of them until the next day they try to make it up or something. So there is no playing around. You are there with the team. This is like when you play football or soccer and you miss a goal and everybody beats you down. Right? It's the same thing. Yeah.
How long do they stay under the water?
1.5 minutes. Maximum
two
minutes really maximum. I don't know if you ever seen. Have you seen a diver? Look, do me a favor, Jumeirah. We have two places. We just did the fishermen's and divers' matches. Here. No problem. But I need the other one, guys. Don't throw us back. No, put it down. Don't let us forget about it. Put it down. But we have majlis where divers and fishermen. If you go see, I love, you know, here when I go and I catch, you know, some time with them and we sit and talk. They're very old, but they're very skinny and huge lungs. If you ever ask one to take a deep breath, you will find it amazing. Very skinny like a Gandhi, and the chest goes up like this. It's like two balloons inside. اقول ان الغواص شلون ضعيف وبعدين ما شاء الله عليه صدره يعني بلور.
زين الحين انا بمشي وانت لا خليك على الغواص. بنتكلم على انواع اللوده.
So this is the types of pearls, real quick.
طبعا الجي 1 جريد 1 معروف حتى بالمصطلح الانجليزي جريد 1. الجي 1
جي 1
جي 1 افضل افضل يعني افضل لولو.
This is rank number 1. This is first class G1.
بعدها الجولوا اللي بعدها
جولا.
جولوا
it's not complete circle but it's good. Second this is like diamonds, you know how diamonds what is it, BS? Yeah, clarity BS1. I remember when I went to bought my wife one, she my hair all about diamonds. البوكا
طبعا الشيرين اسم فارسي
but it's completely circular.
الخشن
نوع من اللون الخشن okay again not beautiful but it's not that great.
الناعمة عندنا الناعمة اللي هي اصل صغيرة البدلة طبعا نوعين مثل الجيوان بس نوع صغير.
Yeah, so tiny tiny small ones. I don't know if you ever seen, we have at our center we have the poster that shows the scale and that shows the different ways of how you like, it's like almost like doing rice or corn. You put it in and different sizes fall and then you have the different.
زين عندنا الفص اللاصقة اللي هي لاصقة في المحارة. لاصقة في المحارة يوم تقول محارة يحصلونها لاصقة داخل.
للحين يعني يظلون الماء.
إيه إيه عندنا المجهولة ما تنعرف هذه شو المجهولة تعرف.
So we have the very small tiny that stuck to the oyster. We have the one that you can't even tell if it's a pearl or not because it's still not completely formed.
أم عويرة مثل العين شكلها مثل العين.
Oval.
إيه مثل العين.
Okay, so there's a one that looks like an eye. It's called we call it eye.
مبحورة لولوة دش البحر داخلها فيها خربة يعني.
There is a hole in it. It's been eaten up. Yeah.
عدسي على شكل العدس.
Looks like a lantern, V.
السحديد أنعم شيء.
Very small, very soft.
السنباسي طبعاً اللون الأزرق للون.
This is when they get color, they sometimes bluish.
الغلابي متقلب اللون.
يعني أبيض على شيء متعلق.
أيوه.
This is the one that has different colors, it kind of like reflects.
الأشقر هو اللون الأصفر الفاتح.
This is light yellow and green.
طبعا هاي اسوء انواع اللون.
The green is not good. Nobody wants. And this is the weights.
هاي الاوزان، الاوزان ليس بالعربي الاوزان هندية.
So this is the method of weighing, it was also exported from India. The terminology of weighing.
مثقال، ذكرى، شو، حبة، رتي، آنب، قام، باية موزة طبعا المثقال والدورة والدوكرة حق اللولو الكبار.
ايوه يعني كبروا اللولو الزين
لا شوف حبة الحمص
قدها تقريبا. تشيك بيس از جود لولو از جود تشيك بيس سايز ان ذوز دايز يو جاب ناو يو ريتش خلاص جود يو كان جو هوم.
زين والاوزان الباجي طبعا حق الاشياء
الصغيرة. سمولر اول ذا واي جود.
هي طبعا هاي زراعة وصناعة اللولو نشوف اللي زرعهن.
Culture pearls. This is the guy in Japan.
Tokishi Mikimito.
Tokishi Mikiyo. Miki.
Mito.
Mito.
Tokishi Mikimito.
He's born in.
هذا اللي اقترح اللولو.
Remember January 1850 because they used to come and get so much from us. Their emperor loved pearls. And so they said, it's costing us too much money, let's make our oil. So they made their oil. Otherwise, nowadays we trade it with elite society folks. We do not trade with your average citizen in any country. We trade it with the emperors, the queens, and the kings.
مولود شوف متى؟
January 25th, 1858, he was born.
حصل على المهنة في سنة 1907.
1907 is when he really began to work on this concept. And by the mid 20s, we definitely began to affect this chemistry.
طبعا في مزرعة في راس الخيمة زراعة ال يعني اللولوة تستغرق 30 ثانية، ازيد عن 30 ثانية يموت المحارة. يعني الشخص اللي يزرع داخل المحارة مثل الصدف. علشان يتكون عليه. فالفترة أو المدة 30 ثانية يحطها بالملقاة، أزيد عن 30 ثانية تموت.
يعني كل المحرم فاتح؟
إيه فاتح المحرم ويجيب الصدفة ويحطها داخل بسرعة. إيه
وبعدين تسكر عليه.
خلاص يتسكر روحها، إذا أخذت مثلا 50 ثانية تموت المحرم. خلاص.
So the oyster opens up. This is what we do in Ras Al Khaimah now. We try to create income for you know the other 5 minutes. When we switch Ras Al Khaimah, we do cultured pearls in Ras Al Khaimah, and we found out that it's nicer than the cultured pearls in Japan in the ocean. In the Gulf, your cultured pearls are still better looking and more beautiful. But the concept here is what he just gave me a new thing that when you insert the tiny. Species or specimen to be able to create the pearl in the oyster, 30 seconds. You have 30 seconds to quickly insert it in the right perfect place for the oyster to close on it. If you take too long, the oyster is already dead. It will not work, it will not grow. So it's really a very tedious process, but it's now being, you know, of course, done in the Ras Al Khaimah, and we think we can have a good, nice industry there. We try actually to keep.
طبعا الملاحه بس هاي طبعا اول خارطه طلعت من المقاسات اللولو الشركه الهنديه البريطانيه سوت عملتها بس الشيخ مانع بن راشد هو اللي حدد عليها المناطق نشوفها الحين الهند نشوفها اسود ابيض طبعا بتطلع عنا بالالوان انا عملتها حوليتها الخارطه بالالوان اشتغلت عليها تقريبا لمده 3 سنوات فبنشوف المناطق هذه طبعا هذه الخارطه وايد قديمه عمنا الشيخ مانع بن راشد آل مكتوب.
So Sheikh مانع بن راشد took this map of the map was produced of the Gulf by Indians and British sailors or what is called geographical people and the Sheikh مانع he spotted on it where the pearl areas are, pearling areas are. And then Juma here he did in color. And it shows you next to which village, which island, which in front of which country. There is Qatar, as you can see, there is UAE, and these are the places in red.
طبعا نعم نشوف المناطق الحمراء هي المناطق اللي كانت تنقص. طبعا نشوف هنا المسافة صغيرة بس المسافة هاي تقريبا من 15 مايل إلى 7 مايل. الطول أم الشيخ تعتبر أكبر هي في دولة الإمارات. طبعا من 15 مايل الى 7
15 مايل باي 7 مايل this big great spot there is one of the biggest largest pearling sites in the country good
just one second
yes
thank you
oh, yeah.
this is
private property
لا لا اللي يبغى الخارطه هاي موجوده عندنا في جمعيه الامارات الوسطى نوزعها بلاش
UAE Diving, Pearl Diving Association. We'll keep your stuff, guys. If you want to ever go visit, you just have to speak Arabic.
نشوف دبي وين؟ نشوف أريل. شوف المسافة.
So this is Dubai. كم هذه المسافة؟
هاي تقريبا 52 مايل بحري. 52 مايل.
أيام غوص على القارب ياخذ كم من فترة؟
لا، الأول ولا الأخير؟
أول.
لا أول تقريبا بيطلع مني الصبح بيوصل هناك تقريبا العصر.
So from
على حسب الرياح يعني على حسب الرياح.
About mid afternoon, this is how long it will take you to get there. This is one of the sites. Good. But again, you keep changing in these days to see because.
شوف هاي دبي ونشوف هذه أريا. مشير. طبعا ليش سموها المشير؟ نشوف كل الهيرات عليها اسم، ليش سموها مشير؟ لأن فيها نوع من الاسفنج. نوع من الاسفنج.
Some sort of foam.
هي مثلا في عندهم هير يسمونه باليراوه، ليش يسمونه بالجراوه؟ شفت الجرو على ذكر الله كان صغير؟ الغواصين الاول يوم يغوصون يقولون نسمه مثل اليرو تحت الماء. ايه فسموه
Each area is named after the texture of the grounds, the kind of animals or stones or rocks there. Maybe something happened. Like there is an area where they used to dive, they always heard like there is a dog parking. So they called it the dog, the parking dog place. yes.
خلاص. كذي تقريبا الحين خلصنا. وإذا عندهم أي سؤال أنا أرسل لي عليه لهم بناخذ أسئلة.
Alright, some questions and answers. That's it. Okay, good. Question, please. Yes.
بس نبغى الرسبان.
الرسبان. Where is the guy? Who has the clip? We said that the start was, you know, 9-10 years old is when you sit and open, 12 years old is when you begin to die. فالبداية 19 سنين النهاية العمر يعني الغواص متى خلاص
في حجم الغواصين يروح ما يرجع تموت
لا لا يعني زيت بالعمر
بالعمر تعرف 65 سنة خلاص هات لي الطاولة هذه اللي خلاها شلها هذه تقريبا لن هي خليها هنا عشان بنحط اللولو okay. ايوه بس so بس
we can show you some pearls guys we can show you some real pearls
فاقول لك من تقريبا يكمل 50 سنه خلاص
50 years it's time for you to quit so you start 9 10 12 depends 50 but of course you can start later but again there are those who start from this is their life there are those who do it for 13 years there are those who start later it all depends just like anything else yes ma'am The best who?
Birds.
Lulu البحرين كان أحسن لولو.
هي في سبب.
What's the reason?
ليش سبب؟ لأن جزيرة البحرين تحيط بها العيون المياه الحلوة. فالماء الحلو دائم يلعب دور كبير في تغيير الألوان.
Sweet water mixed with salty water leads to coloring of the birds to where it's very nice, beautiful coloring. It gives it. So therefore. Being that Bahrain has well marked out Bahrain.
في عيون. الدرجة أن يوم يصير الماء آخر الجزر كانوا بعض الغواصين يجيبون الجرب ويحطونها على الماء اللي يطلع يركبونها عليه علشان يمزون الجرب ماله. يعني كان مثل النافورة تطلع. فكان الماء الحلو يلعب دور كبير
في البحر.
هي تحت البحر طبعاً. هي فكانت العيون المياه الحلوة. تلعب دور كبير في تغيير الوان اللون.
So under sea there is springs, natural springs. Of course under sea who's gonna drink it? So therefore unless there is low tide and the people used to go there and wait for to see something that is nearby those particular shoots of water. So next to the sweet water while there is the salty water, that oyster is beautiful. That's the most beautiful oyster. Or the most beautiful birds inside that ocean. Yes, sir.
Why did they do that in those 4 months and not other months?
Temperature. It's very cold after that, and oyster. The bird mind too. It's your job. The actual mind.
طبعاً المحار شهر. أقول لك المحار شهر 8 بيض. شهر 8. هي الفترة فترة رمي البيوض المحار الدرجة أن الغواصين يروحون السيل اللي بعدها يحصلون محار فالفترة اللي هي يرمي فيها البيض على شكل خيوط الخيط هذا يمشي إذا شفت مثل ما الخيط مال كندورة البيض هذا هو مثل يمشي يمسك بأي شيء صلب يمسك بأي شيء صلب بعد فترة يطلع تقريبا 50 محارة بعد شهرين صارن 20 بعد شهر صارن لين ترسمي المحارة بروحها
Anyone knows the concept or the process of oysters how do they get created?
Sand?
No, that's the pearl inside the oyster but the oyster itself what is the birth of an oyster? Anybody? This is good stuff. The oyster, it's in the mating season or whatever, male, female, all of that, of course, a story, but it's a line, it's like a hairline. And then that line begins to build oysters wherever it lands, between wherever it is on the ground, rocks, wherever it is. And so therefore the season is, when it's cold, that's when they begin the birth process. They mature by June, they are ready now to have something inside of them. So that's the why it is when and when. It's not like you can go, it's like there is the birth season, mating season, and there is the maturity season, which is June, July, August, September, October, and that's when we go diving, finding some of these beautiful birds.
طبعا اللي عندنا لولو طبيعي ولولو زراعي. نشوف الالوان تختلف، اللون الطبيعي طبعا دايم يختلف عن اللون.
I wish I had a camera to put on this, but I guess this is, I'll just give you, this is yellow, can you see it? Natural color? This is natural color. Yellow. This is white. This is natural. I'm sure a queen in the old days, if she had this, then she is like, thank you very much. Yeah, this is good. This is bigger than a chickpea. But can you have in a young man?
لو زاد اللي تشوفها اليوم يمكن مليون شيء توصل لان انا عندي علاقه مع داخل الفردان ودايم اسال من يبيعون بالشو مثلا الشو قول 5000 درهم هاي كم شو فيها؟ يمكن فيها 20 شو او 30 شو.
This is like 20 ounces, let's say, if we were to measure by ounces, each ounce is 5000 درهم. But this is like
يمكن هي مليون توصل
بس هاي مليون درهم in the old days
value لان اللون الطبيعي مو موجود عندي سؤال
natural pearls are not yesterday
how do you tell the difference between a cultivated one and a natural one
شلون نعرف بين الطبيعي
الحين انا اعطي مجموعات اللون وواحد بيشوفون الطبيعي وين شوف الطبيعي الوانه كيف ونشوف الالوان الزراعة كيف؟ طبعا اللون الطبيعي هذاك الزراعة هذا وهذا زراعة بس شوف الطبيعي كيف الوانه تختلف يعني لو هو يشوف يشوف التغيير
You would see color definitely and shape like I told you before the shape of the culture pearls are perfect the shape of the natural pearls is imperfect so when you find the natural perfect one it's amazing yes ma'am Scared or peaceful, right? Thank God my dad was a farmer. I'm not good with the sea. I hate the sea. I drown in 2 feet. I drown in full room. It's here, Dachel. في ناس يعني تصير داخل مرتاحة ومستانسة وحبتنا ولا يوم تصير داخل أنت مخترع وخايف
يعني نحن عندنا في جمعيه زبارات الغوص نطلع من الرحله الى رحلتين الى ثلاث. طبعا ما نغوص الحين خلاص كل سكوبا يعني صعب. اي بس نحن لازم نحدد الاماكن ما في خوف ما في شيء. على فكره السؤال هي يمكن تقول على الخوف. عندنا نحن هني في الامارات صارت هجمه غش مره واحده في سنه 1952. عفوا بعدها مخفيه.
1952.
في كانوا الناس يغوصون فترة الدحة فيتم سمكة قرش ومسكت شخص من هني وراحت عند السفينة الثانية ويعني رجعوا غير العادة فهذه هي تعتبر الهجمة الوحيدة اللي صارت.
We only had one shark attack in 1952. So technically speaking it's always been safe and it's always been. But the concept of dying underwater accidents يعني المخاوف ان مثلا الحوادث تصير
تصير
يوم يموت الغواص
يوم يموت الغواص اذا قربهم جزيره يحفرون لهم يدفنون في الجزيره بس اذا هم في البحر وعندهم مثلا الجيول هذه اللي نشوفها وماشي قربهم جزيره يكفنونه شفت الحصان اللي بسبع ساعات يحطون له واحده في بطنه واحده عندينه وينزلونه في البحر ويغيرون المكان ما يقصون في
بس شو اللي يسبب موت مثلا الغواص؟
سكرة اعماق يمكن اكثر شيء كان يموتون من سكرة اعماق وكان في مس جن. يعني واحد من الغواصين يقول انا غص انا يعني اللقاءات اللي سويتها في راس الخيمه في ابو ظبي يقول واحد انا غصت اول ما وصلت ولا اشوف حرمان ياسر ترضع ولدها
داخل
تحت الماي مره واحد يقول انا شفت واحد ياسر تسقي شعره فكان في مس جن بس اليوم نحن بالاشياء العلميه نقول سرقه اعمار انقطاع الاكسجين في الدم
It's just simply you run out of oxygen, you freak, you panic. The concept of dying and drowning underneath is just simply an instantaneous something that overwhelms you and you cannot overcome it. And by the time you go up, you finish. Or you go up too fast. One thing, of course, we didn't have really autopsies. All we know is so and so died, and we have two ways to bury it. If we are near an island, we go to the island quickly and bury them in the island, and that's it. Otherwise, we put weights in them and we bury them at sea. If we are way inside the sea, whenever. Yes, ma'am?
They were held for about 4 months. You can't bring so much food and fresh water. So
yeah,
I
yeah.
assume it goes by boat, but how do they know where they were?
أكل الماء بحر.
هذا السؤال أنا أسألهم يا كيف كان يوصل الماء وأكل الماء؟ أنا أسألهم السؤال.
So this is for you. This is the question to you. It's like let me ask you this question. Water and food, how? In the sea for 4 months. From where? If you come to our center, we tell you, but now since, yeah. Yeah?
Water containers?
Did
you go to Dalma Island to get rice and to get fresh water?
Dalma? Huh? So the guy is here on Dalma Island.
Dalma, six baladin, you know. Dalma, six baladin. Ahla mai fi Dalma.
Ahla mai. The six baladin.
That's a good
answer. That's a good answer. But still, okay.
زين الأكل سؤال.
Food from where? Fish.
كم نوع fish؟ زين قهوة عيش سكر.
Rice, tea, coffee, sugar.
Oysters.
Do we eat oyster? Do we سلول؟ تأكل المحار؟
ما يروم يأكل المحار بس هاي المدينة هم ما يروم يأكل المحار.
They're not gonna eat oyster. The women aren't seeing. Wrong food for
زين على طاري الاكل طبعا على طاري الاكل في هناك تقريبا 10 سفن واحده تطلع من راس الخيمه واحده تطلع من 10 5 يطلع من البيت 3 من ابو ظبي اي هذه كلهم غوابيس وين هي؟ توقف وحده برا ما تدش داخل عندهم وين يوصلون توقف برا عنهم قال انا ابغي ماي هاي السفينه محمله بس ماي شو يسوي؟ يرفع على انا اعرف انه هو يبغي الماي هذه رفعت على المذر الابيض اعرف انها تبغي اكل بس انا هذا الشخص ما اقدر اعطي 100 جالون اعطي 50 جالون لانه هاي تبغي 50 جالون وهذا يبغي 50 جالون فما تصير الحس انا ما ابيع الماي لكن انا ما ابيع الماي كله عليها هي لا لان في سفن ثاني
فانت السفينه تجيب ماي
هي عندك سفن
السفن اللي تبي الماي
ترفع المحتاجه ترفع متى يجونهم؟ بعد المغرب وقفوا العالم
ماي After sunset, after the diving has stopped, the ships that come for to bring water or food, and each ship raises a certain color flag that indicates I need rice, I need coffee, I need water. So 10 ships at least they go out there in a periodic sense and every whatever how often they need the supplies it's a business they know their stuff and this is how it is you go to that ship grab the water and this is how it works
I'm
telling you life at sea
he said that سؤال دلما كانت بورصة اللولو دلما كانت بورصة اللولو كل السفن والطواويش كانوا يجمعون في دلما فيبيعون اللولو.
دلما is Dubai Mall in the old days, where everybody went to buy pearls. That's it. دلما is the place where everybody went to see what pearls is available. This is an island. I don't know if you guys have ever taken small boats to go around. I remember when we did last year, no, this year, we did the sailboat competition. We took an RTA boat. With about 100 people, and I was on it, and we explained lots of our little islands, and so this is something we could do, like where you go on RTA boats and do a tour of the islands of across from Dubai. Yes, yes, sir. Over there, I'll give you.
How many species of oyster are involved? Just one, or? كم نوع محار داخل
الخليج يعني؟ ها في الخليج تقريبا ثلاث أنواع يسمون المحار الزني اللي هي أكبر محارة. وفي محارة يسمونها المصبورة المسبورة بمعنى أن شفت قنفذ البحر الأسود اللي مشوش هذا إيه ينظف المحارة يأكلها فيسمونها محارة مسبورة على أساس أنها يعني هذا تعتبر صنف أو نوع من أنواع
نظيفة
وفي محارة يسمونها محارة مهنة يعني هاي تنشاف من بعيد هاي ثلاثة أنواع.
So really the names it depends on the looks of it more than anything they are all the same. But one is green because some animals, you know, like what is this, this animal that has the thorn, the sea? What is the name of it?
Sea urchin.
He eats the surface of the outside of the oyster and it becomes very. And there is the big one, there is the, so obvious you see it from distance, and there is. So really, there is nothing. Yes, ma'am.
So, since you dive, I
would
like to know if you consider the
sites
where they go for
pearling
beautiful for divers.
For diving.
أول
يعني
الغواص كم بيجي بيزات في الربع؟ ترى ساعة نزلت. يا. هلا لا شوف الحين جيت أنا أنت لو خذت قلت لك أنا بصير غواص يعني. قلت لي انت غواص الحسبة 100 درهم 150 درهم او 200 درهم او 300 درهم اعطيتك 300 درهم ورجعنا بالغواص وحسبنا طلع مثلا 150 درهم الحسبة للمجموعة كلها اليوم كل شخص يحصل
150
درهم كل الحصل القارب لا الحصل تقريبا كل حصل 3000 4000 بس اي بس توزع الكل بس السيف ياخذ غير والغيس ياخذ غير يمكن كل هالشغلة هذه 200 درهم على الفترة اللي يارس فيها هي 4 شهور يمكن 200 300 درهم 400 درهم.
So the whole boat gets about 3-4,000 درهم divided by everybody you might get 200 درهم sorry for the 4 months.
أكثر من في سؤال في ولد بتسأل الأخوان.
But 200 درهم this is a lot of money. Yeah, my dad used to make 3 درهم a month. We were millionaires at that time. I remember, yes ma'am.
How many on a boat?
The boat is about the boat 15 meters, about 50 feet, and about 20 people on it.
Between all the positions. في 120 في بعد الكبار في 120 شخص يقول لك يعني يمزحون يوم يرجعون من هناك يسلمون على بعض وان اللي قدام في السفينة ما شاف اللي وراء.
This is like the, some of the very, very big boats, few, not that many of them, are like up to 120 people on a boat. But those are very few. The average are the smaller 50 foot boat, yeah.
So what will drink? If I want to buy pearl from you, what should I drink? Coin, gold, or
just a 50 foot? If I buy منك لولو, شخص يجيب دراهم, يجيب ذهب, يجيب So really rupees, which is the Indian currency. I tell you what, I mean, if you go to the Greek, really, in the old days, it's all about what are my needs as a trader. If I am somebody who does good with fabrics, I want fabric. If I am somebody who does good with spices, I want spices. If I'm somebody good who does with gold, with silver, or I just want currency because I have the intention to buy. So really every person who has the pair is looking for something that he wants for his profession or his
business. I wrote 9 books on the sea, and among them, of course, I wrote the Ross and Lulu. ويعتبر من افضل الكتب طبعا كان كتاب الامارات واللؤلؤ وهذا رحله الغوص وعملت رجال الغوص واللؤلؤ طبعا فتقريبا 9 كتب عن البحر.
9 books about the sea, one of which is called Trip to Pearling. And downstairs we will have this is Culture Cafe. I don't know if you, this is your first time to our majlis, but this is where we open every day from 8 in the morning till 6 in the evening. We serve camel milk, chocolate, camel milk lattes and cafes. And the pastries downstairs are actually made at Zabir Palace kitchen. His Highness's Palace. Because this is, we're trying to promote authentic culture and we're trying to take it to a higher level, but slowly.
and we try to see what's going to suit, what's going to make everybody. But these books are available downstairs, and this is his book about birding. I'll give you your question in just a second. This is about fish.
طبعا هذا الأسماك والحياة البحرية في طرف
الإمارات. And the life or marine life in UAE. Questions? Yes, ma'am. كان في شرطة في البحر إنه صار واش على مكان غوص معين ولا لا ما في يمكن ما نختلف يعني no it's okay usually it used to be or we work our differences let's put it that way one more question two more questions and then we'll let everybody go yes Adam
also for 4 months and 10 days while the divers were away
yes
was it a vulnerable time for the women and the families was there some kind of tribal protection how would they take care of
I mean, I can answer you that. Maybe the concept of women, of course, there was some young guys left to protect, but the, our women guys are strong. They are, they're scared of them. That's what they always ask me, do Emirati like to marry outside the UAE? Yeah, Emirati like to marry outside the UAE because it's much easier. This, but there is protection, there is assistance too, and in each family, there is who's going to stay behind to take care of the women. Yes, definitely, absolutely. Yes?
Nassim, you were talking about pearling, but you never see in the old jewelry of the ladies any pearls.
No worries. Let's have him in my episode, Lulu, Layam, Harvey.
Lulu,
what do you do more?
Do you have it? Natural. White, Harvey.
Expensive.
White.
I mean the زراعي غالي ولا
لا لا طبيعي غالي وايد هذا مو موجود
natural is not available I don't know really it's just one of those traditions that yeah it's not impressive I mean my wife has a very nice necklace with the small ones like about 7 layers and a bracelet nobody's impressed with it when she wears it
And
you know, in the old days we did not really wear it, our women weren't going to wear it, we want to sell it so we can get what? Money so we can live. You're not going to wear it now, these are days of course, but nobody's impressed, everybody wants diamond, you know, the diamond ring. Yeah. My wife diamond ring, I tell her when she goes shopping, wear it inside out. Well, everything goes up in the price. I don't know how people notice it when she first walk in, they notice her ring. You ladies are young. You have a helmet, yes? Like how many pearls inside an oyster?
I mean,
من كل كم محاري يحصلون لول؟
تقريبا يحصلون يوصلون في مكان يطلعون 2000 محارة ما يحصلون ولا لولو.
Could be 2000 oysters, zero lulu, zero pearls.
يمكن يحصلون 10 محارات يمكن يحصلون 200 لولو.
Mm-hmm. It could be 10 oysters and 20, 100. Oh, the small tiny ones, they could be 50 in one oyster. 50 in one oyster, the small tiny one. If you want to take a picture in Mukhaliya and Shaytan, if you want to take a look here, I'm going to try and end it. One last question. So you can come take a look at the birds, take a picture, yes sir?
It's like, how many years does it take
for
a parent to form?
3 years.
3 years.
3 years.
So after 3 years, the pair forms. Again, I want to thank everybody for participating tonight. Thank you so much. Follow our social media, SMCCU Dubai. Or come and join us 6 days a week. We are open. But I hope you've enjoyed this special series. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
No fighting.
The war, yes.
Thank you.
معلش انا عندي سؤال بس الغيص كان بياخد فلوس من اللوخة ده ما كانوش بيدفعوا زي ضمان ليهم وهم طالعين من الرحلة او
تسلم